Good morning. Welcome to Unity San Diego Spiritual Community. Whatever time of day it is, where you are and where you're listening, we thank you so much for being here. We have a beautiful service for you today, and our message is the wisdom to blossom. Thank you for coming. Have a blessed week.
I am love.
Just around the corner. And dear Spirit, we thank you. We thank you for all the blossoms and the buds that are available to us everywhere we go. It's a new beginning. And we ask today for wisdom. We ask for the wisdom to be able to blossom and to grow within our lives. Thank you. Thank you, Spirit, for the beautiful opportunity to experience another spring. Amen.
Start our day with a little bit of love.
Good morning, everybody. Hi. Welcome. Hello, everybody.
Good morning.
Yeah, good morning. Welcome to our live streaming service and our Sunday service. I'm Reverend Edith Washington Woods, Senior Minister here at Unity San Diego, and Reverend Carla Leitner, our Associate Minister.
Hello.
And we'd like to welcome you here on this day. But let us open with prayer. Let's pray. God, all there is, infinite presence. We're giving thanks for this day. For we know that this is the day that God has made. It is the most important day that we have. We can't go back to tomorrow. We can't go back to yesterday or to tomorrow. So we're asking that each of us are able to stay present in this day. We pray that everyone is able to discover something about themselves and they're able to blossom. We give thanks for the living, moving activity of God within us, around us, and everywhere. In this moment we pray, and so it is. And if you'll say our affirmation with me, we have it on the screen. Let's say it together. Guided by infinite wisdom and prospered by divine love, we move forward in unity to realize our spiritual potential. And then we're going to tell you about our vision and mission statements. Our vision statement is bigger than we could ever imagine here at Unity San Diego. So we'd like it to be imagined with all of you. If we could say it together, please. A world powerfully transformed through the growing movement of shared spiritual awakening. And then we have our mission statement. Our mission statement is who we know ourselves to be, and we're sure you're already experiencing it as well, but we want to share it with the world. Let's say that together. Empowering personal growth through positive spiritual principles, inspirational music, and community service. And guess what, folks? You're going to hear a little bit more inspirational music with our opening hymn, I Love Myself by Jai Michael Joseph.
This is a great song about loving yourself, loving others, and then loving the entire world. Everything. I love my
myself the way I am, and still I want to grow. The change outside can only come when deep inside I know.
Now it's time for us to place a greeting in the chat box, and here's what we're going to say today. I love you and me just the way we are. I love you and me
just the way we are.
I love you and me just the way we are.
I love you and me just the way we are.
Now it's time for our announcements.
Now we have some announcements. You know, Unity was founded on healing and prayer. And so Akosua Washington Woods, who is working towards becoming a licensed Unity teacher, has a wonderful class studying Myrtle Fillmore, our co-founder's Healing Letters Workshop. It's from Mondays from 11 to 1 p.m. It began the beginning of March, but I believe you can still step in.
Yeah.
And it goes until the end of March. So if you are interested in getting some really foundational unity into your life and into your heart, email Monica at unitysandiego@gmail.com for that link.
And I am continuing on my New Year book study that we have, Mark Nepo, More Together Than Alone. And we meet on Mondays through the end of March, from 6:30 to 8 p.m. Pacific time. You could just jump on in and just come, and you'll be able to dive in, really, even if you haven't read it. And again, if you want the email, the link, send an email to Monica at unitysandiego@gmail.com, and she'll send you the link.
And we are still working on the four agreements. Why are we taking so long? Because these agreements really shape our life. We're now working on the third agreement, don't make assumptions. How easy it is to assume. So this is on Thursday nights at 7 p.m. Now you don't, it's a part of our spiritual recovery group, but if you want to be in recovery from making assumptions, just show up. Just email me, RevCarlaLeitner@gmail.com, or my number is on the screen, and I'll be happy to give you the link. Our group has grown. This is a powerful group that we spend 4 weeks on each agreement. So really hoping to see you there.
And now I'd like to invite you to relax and listen to the meditation song, Center Me, by Letty Hammack and Sue K. Riley.
Wisdom is at the right hand.
Center me. Just take a moment to say these two words. Center me. And allow the vibration of the words to simply invite you to relax. Relaxing as we take in those words, center me. Relaxing and noticing how our body responds. I invite you to take a gentle breath in, a conscious breath. Just noticing how the lungs fill up. Expanding and releasing. Expanding and collapsing. We say to ourselves, center me. And as we allow ourselves to just gently move even deeper into this experience, all we need to capture is those two words, center me. And we move into a time of silence, where we dare to allow ourselves to blossom even more fully. Expanding our capacity to be. as we join in this moment, our hearts and minds, we are joining with all there is, the center, that which is everywhere and in everything. As we go into silence, we consciously connect with that source beingness, the center of all things. And we say even more to ourselves, center me. Center me. Center me. I am. I am. I am centered. I am centered. Allow these words to be yours. I am centered. We know and understand that as we bring this to our own innermost beingness, that the vibration of those words are radiating out to those in our homes, those outside of our homes, and into the world. I am centered. And we bring these words from ourselves to everyone, as we blossom together. And for this, we're so grateful. And so it is, for it is us. And we let it be. And now we have the Lord's Prayer.
Hallowed be thy name, hallowed be thy name, hallowed be thy name, hallowed be thy name, sing it one more time, hallowed be thy name, hallowed be thy name. Be thy name.
to temptation.
Hallowed be thy name.
But deliver us from evil.
Hallowed be thy name.
For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory.
In times of trouble, Mother Mary comes to me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be. This song I think everyone's familiar with, and I'm so happy to be able to sing it for you. When we find ourselves in darkness, let it be, because sometimes God has a plan for us. All the time God has a plan for us, so let it be. Enjoy this one. I find myself in times of trouble. Mother Mary comes to me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be. And in my hour of darkness, she is standing right.
Let it be.
rocking out in church.
I like a rocked out church. I don't know about y'all. What a wonderful song. Let It Be. Our wonderful music team under the direction of our music director, Ron Consol. So what does it mean to let it be? Speaking words of wisdom? Okay. But the song talks about us speaking words of wisdom, and then to let it be, and then there'll be an answer. So I was wondering about that. As I thought about what it would be I would talk about today. And I looked in my yard and I noticed something. I noticed some roses. I cut them this morning. This one, you wouldn't know what it is really, but it would be a rose if I left it on a bush at some point. And then the next one opens up a little bit, and now it's starting to look like a rose, right? Oh, that looks like a rose, doesn't it? Each of these have wisdom infused in it. Each of them. Even before they became this little bud, when it's like a branch or a leaf. And the leaf has this intelligence in it that it can only be a rose at some point. Now, do every single one of the leaves become a rose? No. Because some of them aren't meant to be a rose. They're actually meant to be just a leaf, and that's okay. But they go through stages. So this rose is opening up a bit, and this one's opened quite a bit, and now it's starting to have some withering. When we think about the wisdom to blossom, then we can know that all of these are very important in the cycle of life. And then at some point, it becomes even more shriveled up, and the petals fall. And they fall. But there is this wisdom that is within everything. And the roses that I've shown here and on the screen are merely just examples of how we get to live inside of the ability to be, to allow us to speak words of wisdom just like the roses do. For they're speaking to us. They're saying, I'm here. I'm here for the time I'm here. And then I'm complete. Now, our Bible verse, we have some Bible verses for today that come from Ecclesiastes chapter 7, verse 8, and then verses 10 through 12. So they're on two slides because I didn't want to give you a lot of words on one. But in verse 8, it says this: better is the end of a thing than its beginning. The patient in spirit are better than the proud in spirit. And verse 10 says, do not say, why were the former days better than these? For it is not from wisdom that you ask this. In other words, just a little metaphysical interpretation of this. What do we want with former days? We want to go back. We want to go back to over a year ago. We want to go back to February 2020. We want to go back to December 2019 when we had a full house for our concert. We want to go back to when we were able to have time in the fellowship hall after service, having our coffee and tea, having all of our sweets and salty, I call them zuzus and wham-whams. That's where my mind goes, being a parent of kids, right? And I have to interpret. But guess what? We're not going back. Why? Because we have today. Why? Because we have today. We have today with each other. And we speak these words of wisdom knowing that it will be whatever we can create it to be. In verse 11 of Ecclesiastes 7, it says this about wisdom, that wisdom is as good as an inheritance, an advantage to those who see the sun. 12, for the protection of wisdom is like the protection of money, and the advantage of knowledge is that wisdom gives life to the one who possesses it. So if we go back to the rose, it is beauty in it. There is beauty in all of that that it is of it. My guess is it must have, we must have had some cold nights here lately. I just got back just before midnight last night. And I could tell the weather by looking at these roses, because they don't want to be cold, not too cold. And so they had a reaction to it. And yet, the wisdom of it is that they're still beautiful. They're still fragrant. I can smell them. But what do we want to do when they start looking a little bit less than perfect, like the roses on the screen you see? We want to discard them. Oh, they're not perfect anymore. We want to let them go. But in verse 11, it talks about wisdom being of good inheritance and an advantage to those who see the sun. The roses see the sun. But the roses aren't the only ones who see the sun. We see the sun as well. In order for us to grow and blossom, we need the sun. We are affected by the sun. The sun is like wisdom, you know, giving life to not only the roses that I was showing in my example, but also giving us the rays of the sun. Not too hot, not too cold, just enough. See, we're talking about wisdom, and wisdom is our spiritual power of the month, this month, March. And the disciple that is represented by wisdom is James, son of Zebedee. The color is yellow. So some of us wear yellow. And the location of it in our body is the pit of our stomach. Charles Fillmore, the co-founder of Unity, said that wisdom is the intuitive knowing, like spiritual intuition, the voice of God within. I always say, if we're talking about our belly, we're talking about our gut. You know that good gut, good gut. Yeah, okay, let's say that, good gut. The good gut feeling that we get sometimes, that we get to something stirring around that says, oh, I'm supposed to do this or not. And when we listen, we listen and we blossom. We blossom with the spirit that is running through us. And when we don't listen, you know, something doesn't happen, right? I don't know what it is, you know, if you recall any of those times. But we're talking about wisdom here. You know, We can discard these roses that don't look perfect. We can discard the sun. We can discard so many things that we think aren't important anymore. Now, Mark Nepo, in the book that we're reading, right here, he says, we're always capable of doing things, both, right? Like throwing away and discarding things or keeping them. Of destroying the world out of vengeance and creating a new world out of loss. So what happens when the little rose withers up? If we discard it where there's dirt and whatnot, it decomposes. It becomes minerals and nutrients to Mother Earth. And more blooming can happen. If we just throw it on a concrete, you know, sidewalk or something, if the wind doesn't blow, then it just kind of shrivels up, goes away, and that's it. But hopefully, in the darkest of the night, it will find its way to Mother Earth, and they will become one. It's kind of like that for us, too, you know. That we don't wither up and die. We never do. That there's always this new beginning when an ending is happening, and when the ending is happening, there's a new beginning that we step into. And I'm moved by that fact of how when our own physical bodies are complete, which they will be, that we move and cross over into another way of being called pure spirit. And I believe we ride on eagle's wings. Can you imagine that? The span, the graciousness to just soar. But right now, here on earth, as we allow ourselves to live inside our body and to love ourselves so much that we love others too, that is where the wisdom to blossom grows. It just simply grows. You see, good things always come out of something old or discarded, if we have the wisdom to look beyond the veil of beauty. Back to the rose. It's not that it's not beautiful. When we take off the shield that is old and withered, then we can see that it's actually vibrantly alive. There were still green leaves growing on that branch. That because this part of it needed to complete and fall to the ground and become nutrients, that this part was continuing to grow and prosper. That is why it's so important for us to understand the wisdom to blossom. I'm going to ask you a question. Can our blossoms be fuller if we are willing to step into the shoes of those who have opposite views than us? Like if we look at the rose differently, can we look at ourselves differently? Can we look at other people differently? Can we judge less? I think that if we take this question on, we will bloom bigger, more boldly, and vibrantly than we ever have before. Are we willing to step into someone else's shoes? Because their point of view just may be different than ours because of the way that they're seeing it, right? Like If you're looking at this prayer box, you can see the front of it, it looks a certain way, but I'm looking at the back of it and it looks a different way. And yet, it's still the same thing. Looking at someone else's views by standing in their shoes. You know, Mark Nepo, he said a few things. That one of the most compelling functions of community is to let the fullness of life, harshness and all, shape our sensibilities while protecting each other from the difficult aggressions that surround us. And at its best, community serves as a trellis on which the delicate flowers of humanity can grow and blossom. I'm going to say that again. At its best, community serves as a trellis on which the delicate flowers of humanity can grow and blossom. Wow. Think about it. A trellis has to be built. You have to have some tools. You have to have something to screw the nails in, or, well, not the nails, but the screws. You hammer the nails, you screw the screws. Someone to take it and pull it all together, putting grips on it. Otherwise, it couldn't happen. It has to have a hand in order to handle the tools so that we can then build the trellis to put the flowers on. And then we have a tool to cut the flowers, another tool used by a hand. All of them working together for the good. Well, Mark Nepo says again in our book that the truth is that in the face of adversity, the tool is only as useful as the hand that lifts it. The tool is only as useful as the hand that lifts it. And the hand is only as useful as the mind and heart that guide it. In any given moment where love becomes visible, my friends, mind and heart and hand and tool are one. Mind and heart and hand and tool are one. We cannot build it if we don't bring it together. We're more together than alone. We bring our hearts, we bring our minds so that we grow and prosper one moment, one hour, and one day at a time. And our affirmation for today will assist us this week, and it is, I am wise, blooming one petal at a time. Can we say that together, please? I am wise, blooming one petal at a time. Isn't that precious? Just take that in and imagine that you and the rose are one, that you and the trellis are one, that you and the tools are one. And together we blossom and we say, I am wise, blooming one petal at a time. In this moment, we are so grateful to let it be. Amen and namaste.
And for our hymn, it's in every one of us. Most of us have heard this song, but we may not have heard the verses on this. So PJ is going to lead us on the verses, and we're all going to sing on the choruses. Here we go. One, two, and...
Thank you. taking and watching only half of the show. But there's a scenery and lights and a case of thousands who all know what I know.
So next week, I'm going to give the sermon, Living Above the Line. So please join me next week, March 21st at 10 a.m., right here at Unity San Diego. So now is our time of giving and receiving. And we have a basket here, over here, that would represent what we would be passing around should we be meeting here in the sanctuary. But we also, you're also able to give your love offerings and tithes online. You just go to our website. Click the donate button right from where you're watching. And we also have PayPal. We can use your credit card or debit card. It's so much easier than before. Our mailing address is on the screen, and you're also invited to mail in a check. Now, as we do our time of giving and receiving, we have an offering that's here on our screen. So I invite you to take your offering in your hand or place your hands on your heart, so that you can give a little bit of love as we say our offering blessing twice out loud and once in the silence. Together, please. I am one with God's gifts. They overflow and enrich my life. I bless the gifts and share from infinite good. And again, I am one with God's gifts. They overflow and enrich my life. I bless the gifts and share from infinite good. And then once in the silence of your hearts. And we are so blessed and so grateful to be able to enrich the lives of others and enrich our own lives by sharing that which we have to give. And we say thank you. Thank you, God. And so it is. Amen.
So as many of you know, I work in the musical theater department at San Diego State. I have access to, like, every musical ever written, almost. this song is from not Nonsense the musical, and not Nonsense 2. This is from Nonsense 3, Jamboree. So probably a lot of you have seen Nonsense. I had the privilege of seeing the late Priscilla Allen play Mother Superior here in San Diego. And if you don't recognize that name, if you've ever seen Total Recall with Arnold Schwarzenegger, she was the costume he wore at the spaceport, and he took off her head and it exploded. That was Priscilla Allen, and she lived here in San Diego. So there's a cool fact for today. But this is, the funny thing for this is, it's not, we've all heard the term pearls of wisdom. That's not this song. We have little, mini pearls of wisdom to share with you this morning. And if you're going to hear something funny behind me, that's PJ playing not the banjo or the guitar, but the ganjo, which is...
Don't tell them my secret.
So it's like it's a guitar that sounds like a banjo, so it's called a ganjo. So this is mini pearls of wisdom. We're all good?
Almost all good.
Are we...
Here, so we're doing a quick switch.
Oh. Are we dedicating it to Minnie Pearl?
Well, it's one of you would have had to wear a hat with the price tag. And nobody did.
Didn't think of it. Yeah, no, actually, I got to see Bea Arthur in the role of Mother Superior here in San Diego.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, that would have been hilarious.
Oh, she was amazing.
Rue McClanahan has played it several times,
yeah,
in both one and two.
Yeah.
We just got to keep talking until we
get it. Not right, really.
We're ready.
Oh, you're ready. Oh,
all right,
okay.
Cool.
This is Minnie Pearls of Wisdom.
He's playing the banjo part. That's a
we
part
got,
of it.
We got these little things, little pearls of wisdom to share with you. Here we go.
Many pearls, we've got many pearls of wisdom here for you. We've got many pearls of wisdom, yes we do. We found experts and we quizzed them to get many pearls of wisdom. Now it's time to share those many pearls with you.
Take a chance, there's a chance you might be right.
If you ain't got money, you better be polite.
Don't ask questions if you don't want to know.
When everything is going wrong, tell them you won't go.
What's easy to untie?
Don't spit in the well, you'll get thirsty by and by.
It ain't if you win or lose, it's where you place the blame. But don't forget her.
His
name.
We've got many pearls of wisdom here for you. We've got many pearls of wisdom, yes we do. We have experts and we quizzed them to get many pearls of wisdom. Now it's time to share those many pearls with you.
If your halo slips, it could turn into a noose.
If you can't be kind, kindly be obtuse.
Don't try to fix things when they ain't broke.
If you paid up your insurance, go ahead and smoke.
If you can't do it, teach it. If you can't teach it, teach phys ed.
If you ain't wearing underpants, don't stand on your head.
Pull off them tomorrow, what you should never do.
Hey, if you can't convince them, then confuse them through and
many pearls of wisdom, yes we do. And there's one more mini pearl that we would like to leave with you. When assembly is required for your catalog selection, after everything you've tried has failed, read the directions.
I hope that helped, little pearls of wisdom.
That was so fun. I really thought it was Minnie Pearl. I'm like, I should have brought a hat with the, you know, the price tags on it. That was so fun. I love you guys. You guys are great. Well, we want to thank everybody for their your gifts. We want to thank you all for your gifts, for your tithes, for your love offerings. And we also, I have what Mahatma Gandhi said. He said, where there is love, there is life. Where there is love, there is life. Let's take that for a moment into prayer here. Where there is love, there is life. And as we focus on the best life possible, on the things that we know are deeply important within, we are so grateful and so blessed that we are able to share and to give. Not only to give, but also to receive. There are so many, many blessings. Not only financially, but spiritually, emotionally, mentally, physically. There's so many things that we can share, the love with each other. We are so grateful that you tithe here where you are spiritually fed, and allow us and help us to spread this message of unity, this message of positivity and love. We say thank you, God, and so it is. Amen. Well, as I said before, Unity is founded on prayer. We have a wonderful prayer ministry here. It's actually available by phone Monday through Friday from 12 noon till 5 p.m. The telephone number is on the screen, but you know what? You could leave a message at any time, and they will get back to you. They hold your prayer in confidence. They send you a beautiful card and affirmation in the mail, and they also pray for 30 days with you. We also have Silent Unity, which is available by phone or email 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, every single day of the year. They also pray with you for 30 days. Keep that prayer of yours in confidence. And what a beautiful blessing it is that we have these sources available to us. We also have prayer chaplains that are continuously holding all of us in prayer. You know, prayer works, and what better way to have a whole group of people that are in our prayer corner, in our prayer partners with us. And so we are so blessed to have all of these people praying for us. We have our prayer box here that Reverend Edith spoke about earlier today. And she let us know that this beautiful box is here to hold our prayers, to hold prayers that we're thinking in our minds. We might not even have thought of them yet. Represents the prayers that we've emailed, we've spoken. We know that every word is a prayer. So let's take a moment to pray over those prayers that you've talked about, spoken about, emailed about, and hold in your heart. Mother, Father, God, sweet, sweet Spirit, we know that each and every word we say is a prayer for what we want. Is a prayer for the highest good. And as we focus our attention on that which is the best, on positivity and love, on the highest good for all, we know without a shadow of a doubt that divine order is in charge. And we pray for this or something better, always knowing that our prayers are answered. And we say, thank you, God. And so it is. Amen. Please join me now, friends, to sing More Than Enough, the words and music by Daniel Naaman.
There is more than
prayer for protection. Together, please. The light of God surrounds us. The love of God enfolds us. The power of God protects us. The presence of God watches over us. Wherever we are, God is, and all is truly well. Thank you so much for joining us today, friends. Namaste.
This week, everybody.